Hey everybody, welcome back. As we all know, Call of Duty Next is right around the corner. On September 15th, we're going to be seeing the next iteration of Call of Duty with the multiplayer reveal for Modern Warfare 2. We're going to get some new information and possibly even gameplay details and gameplay itself recorded and streamed of the new Warzone experience. And we're also going to be seeing our very first official look at Warzone Mobile. Over the past few hours, we've been seeing a ton of people on social media receive actual physical invites to this event. These invites feature Ghost, and they include a note that says, "You're invited to an exclusive event where you'll get hands-on experience with Modern Warfare 2. You'll be able to stream and capture never-before-seen Call of Duty gameplay to share with your community." So this is great, and it honestly reminds me of the event that happened with the original Modern Warfare release. I mean, think about it this way. They invited so many people to this event back in 2019 that even TmarTns went and uploaded to his main channel about it, which I have some clips of it from here, from his video. I'll put linked in the description below if you'd like to see the entire thing. But this event was huge. There were so many people there, and I feel like they're gearing up to do it again this year with Modern Warfare 2. Now, unfortunately, I won't be attending this event, but I'll definitely be watching along with everybody back at home, and I will be covering the event from my PC, talking about gameplay and all of the things that they're going to be revealing. If it comes down to it, I'll try to get some gameplay if maybe another content creator is allowed to share gameplay with me, but I highly doubt that they're going to be allowed to do that. Either way, though, I will be covering the event here from home, and I look forward to it. Plus, I'm sure on that day, they're also going to be doing a multiplayer reveal trailer, which I'm really looking forward to. I think Modern Warfare 2019's multiplayer reveal trailer is one that sticks out in my head as being one of the best. It's just super memorable, and I think that that translated really well in-game. But the interesting part about how this reveal is going to be done, right after the multiplayer reveal trailer, they're jumping directly into gameplay, so there's no real reason to do a breakdown of the trailer like we would have done in previous years. We're going to see actual gameplay and what we can expect for the beta right out the gate. So we're going to be getting information about the Gunsmith, multiplayer, Warzone Mobile, Warzone 2, and possibly even some campaign stuff from this particular event. It's going to be a fun-filled day, and I cannot wait to talk about it all right here with you, and then experience it all with you, because on the 16th, that's when the early beta goes live on the PlayStation, so it's going to be happening right after the event. Switching gears a little bit and heading back to Vanguard. The Vanguard season has come to a close in terms of competitive. LA Thieves ended up taking the victory over Atlanta FaZe during COD Champs. I would say that the Atlanta FaZe put up a really good fight. I think that they tried to claw back the best that they could, but they were down 4-0, and they tried to reverse sweep, and it wasn't a possibility. At first, I thought maybe there was some chance there, but LA Thieves were just way too dominant, and, well, they ended up closing out the victory and getting $1.2 million. I'm sure it stings, but it probably stings a little bit less knowing that second place still gets $650,000. Anyway, the reason I bring this up is because the lead game designer over at Treyarch, Lawrence Metten, actually went on to Twitter earlier today asking, "With Champs and the 2022 CDL season behind us, I'd love to talk ranked play. We rolled out some big updates to the ranked format this year. What did you like and what would you like to see changed or added in the future? Your feedback helps shape the game." This is a really, really important thing, and I wanted to put this out there because if you are a fan of ranked, if you're a fan of playing competitive or league play or any of the sorts like that, this is your opportunity to give the feedback directly to the person that's going to be making those changes. And we already know that there's a pretty big rumor that Treyarch will be doing the ranked play section of Modern Warfare 2. And if this tweet is cryptic enough saying, "What would you like to see changed or added in the future?" it kind of just lets us know that, yeah, ranked play is going to still be developed by Treyarch themselves. So this is a good opportunity to get in your feedback, to make those changes or shape the way things are going to be happening moving forward into the MW2 season. Now, of course, it's not officially confirmed, but if they're asking for details on what could be made better, I would assume that this is the unofficial confirmation that they're going to continue working on ranked play moving forward into the future. And I don't think that future includes Vanguard, if I'm being completely honest with you. So if you're one of those players that played through the Vanguard season, maybe you didn't necessarily like certain aspects of it, maybe you really loved certain aspects of it, now's your chance to give that feedback. So in the description below, I will put a link to this tweet. please give your feedback to Lawrence. I think it's very important that they get as much feedback as humanly possible. Lawrence doesn't have that many followers on Twitter, so I'd really love to expand his reach over there, especially when it comes to things like this. So make sure to hit him up, give your constructive feedback, and hopefully you'll see the changes made in the future. And speaking of the future, I want to talk a little bit about what I plan on doing content-wise moving forward into the Modern Warfare 2 season. As we all know, Season 5 for Vanguard and Warzone will be releasing this month, I believe on the 23rd of August. It hasn't officially been confirmed, that's just when the battle pass ends, that's when the countdown timer comes to a close. Season 5 is rumored to be the final season of Vanguard. With Season 5, just like the previous four that we've had, I'm sure there's going to be two multiplayer maps, a couple of new weapons, and maybe, you know, a few new operators. I don't know if they're planning on doing any brand new operators or if this is the season that they're going to fall back on those returning villain operators that we talked about a couple of days ago. Either way, what I plan on doing is, of course, covering Season 5, covering all the stuff that's going to be happening in Vanguard, and maybe the new potential Easter eggs that are found in Warzone that could be leading to the story and giving us a little bit more information about Modern Warfare 2, because it's right around that time we start to see this stuff. So I will be covering all of that when it ends up dropping. But as soon as MW2 beta ends up coming through, I'm probably going to switch all of my content to MW2 moving forward. I probably won't be covering Vanguard as much unless there's an update of some sort, or if there is, for some reason, surprisingly, a Season 6 that eventually does end up coming through. I don't really think that's going to be the case, but I will cover that from time to time. But a majority of my focus is going to go to MW2. I just really can't stand playing Vanguard. I'll be completely honest with you. I'm burned the fuck out on this game. I just can't stand playing it. I can play it for short bursts, like maybe an hour or two max, 2 hours max. But other than that, I can't bring myself to do it. I still haven't finished the battle pass for Season 4. That's just how little I've been playing it this season. It's just really weird that there's really been no cohesion with the story like we have had in previous years. And it's not like the pollination between Vanguard and Warzone is even a thing. It's like we have these crossover events, but then the event challenges and stuff don't cross over into Vanguard like we've seen in the previous couple of years. It's just, it's all downhill, man. It's just all really, really bad. So I, for one, am really looking forward to moving on, and I just kind of wanted to make it known that in the future, when the MW2 beta comes out, I'm probably going to exclusively upload Modern Warfare 2 gameplay moving forward. The only thing that's going to change that is if there is a Season 6 or something to Vanguard, or if there's a big overhaul or an update. Of course, I'll have Vanguard gameplay, but other than that, I'm full steam ahead with MW2. I'm really, really hoping that the developers learned from the mistakes that Sledgehammer made this year with multiplayer, and I'm really, truly, truly hoping that if they continue to go through with the seasonal content like they have been, please, I'm begging you, Infinity Ward, please put emphasis on multiplayer. Not everybody is a Warzone player. Not everybody even enjoys jumping into Warzone. People reluctantly do to get the challenges this year. That's pretty much what it boiled down to for a lot of multiplayer people. And I'm just hoping that they can return to their former glory in giving multiplayer a fighting chance. It's a premium title. We're paying $70 now a year to get this game. The least they can do is actually support it. But anyway, that's all I got to say about it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming every day. Ring that bell icon, join the notification squad, and I'll see you all on the next video. Peace.